In today's lesson, we're going to learn the first two choruses of Grant Green's solo on the tune Blues for Juanita. So I'll play it for you first, and then we'll walk through it. Hello, and welcome to Jazz Blues Guitar, where we learn jazz one chorus at a time, or sometimes two, like in today's lesson where we'll go over the first two choruses to Grant Green's solo, The Blues for Juanita, a tune he wrote for his 1963 album, The Latin Bit. So let's jump right into it. Okay, before we get started, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss a video. Also, I'll leave a link for a free PDF to follow along with. And so the video doesn't go too long, I'm not going to go over the head, but I'll include it in the PDF. So the tune is a B-flat blues, and it starts off like this. So what he's doing there is he starts off on the root, and then slides into the 11, and then just runs down the B-flat blues scale like this. Landing on the 13th there. So a little slower. And you'll notice I'll land on that 13 with my middle finger there to set up the next line, which goes like this. And what's happening there is he's just going a half step below and then running up an A flat major 7 arpeggio. And the A-flat major 7 arpeggio works really well over the B-flat 7 because you're hitting the 7th, the 9th, the 11th, and the 13th, and then back to the root. And then as that B-flat 7 chord changes into the E-flat 7, you're just hitting the root a few times and then the flat 7 too. So now all together. And then the next line that takes us back to the B-flat 7 from the E-flat 7 goes like this. So in the E-flat 7, you're just hitting the flat 7 to the 9th. And then doing a little blues lick once you get back to the B-flat 7. From there we go. So what he's doing there is he's resting on the D minor 7 and doing a little half step below to the 3rd of the G7, to the 5th, to the 7th, to the flat 9, to the root, and then back to the 7th, or flat 7th I guess. And then as the chord changes to an F7 he goes, which is just the flat 7 and the 13 of the F7. And then to end this first chorus, he does a blues lick that takes us back to the B-flat 7. Okay, so now on to the second chorus, leading into it, and then the first four bars, he's basically just playing this little five-note segment of the blues scale. Which sounds like this. Again, a little slower. And he's hitting that E flat as we go to the E flat 7. So the next phrase is a little longer. I'll play the whole thing, but then I'll break it up so we can see what's going on. So for the first part of the line, he's just running down the blues scale again, but then outlining the B flat 7 when he gets to there. So the blues scale. And then on the B flat 7, he goes third, root, 7, and then just does a little lower neighbor down to the fifth of the B flat 7. So again. So on the D minor 7, he's just doing like a little upper neighbor chromatic on the root down to the flat 7. And then as it goes into the G7, it's kind of a variation on that G7 we did before, where we went 3, 5, 7, flat 9, root. But here he's, instead of going up to the third, he's sliding down to the third of the G7. So he's going to the third, to the fifth, to the seventh, flat 7, sorry. And then instead of going to the flat 9, he goes sharp 9 to the flat 9. So. So here's the D minor 7 going into the G7 again. So I'll play that whole line again a little bit slower. So to end this second course, we're going to do another major seventh arpeggio on a seventh chord, this time on the F7, which sounds like this. And just like before on the B-flat 7, where we started the major seventh chord off of the flat 7 tone of that B-flat 7, we're going to do the same thing here. But since we're on the F7, our flat 7 is the note E flat. So we're going to be arpeggiating an E flat major 7. And again, starting off with a little half step below. But here he does a little chromatic enclosure of that 13. Then he goes back to the 11. To the root of the F7, and then a little chromatic passing tone to the flat 7, and then jumps up to the fifth of the chord, then to the third, leading right to the root of that B flat 7, then to the 7 of that B flat 7, and then hits that 13, and then this is probably just a passing tone to lead us back to that F7 and end the line. So here it is all together. One more time. So there you go, Blues for Juanita, a fun blues to play with some great phrasing. I hope to see you next time, and please don't forget to subscribe.